To write the chemical formula for an acid, when you're given its name, we follow just a few basic rules. It's sort of the reverse to writing the name when you're given the formula. We'll start with hydrochloric acid, something you probably know is HCl. We can see that hydrochloric acid begins with the prefix hydro, and that the only rule that begins with hydro is right here. These don't begin with hydro. It also ends in ic. So that matches our pattern here. We have hydro ending in ic, so these are the rules we're going to use to write the formula for hydrochloric acid. First thing we do is we write H. That's what makes this an acid. Next, we look at the stem, that's the CHLOR, and then we go to the periodic table to find the element that this is going to be. So we go to the periodic table, we see that's chlorine, so we write Cl, and now we need to balance the charges. Chlorine has a negative one charge, hydrogen has a plus charge. Because of that, the plus and the minus, they balance out, and we're left with HCl as the formula for hydrochloric acid. So pause for a moment and try hydrofluoric acid. Note that fluorine's in the same group on the periodic table as chlorine. That means its anion, it's going to have a negative one charge. For hydrofluoric acid, we'll first write H, and then we have this FLOUR. We look on the periodic table and fluorine matches pretty well. So we put an F here. Remember we said H is plus one and it's always plus one. And the fluorine, same group as chlorine, it'll have that negative charge. So plus and minus, those cancel out. And the formula for hydrofluoric acid is HF. Okay, so you understand how to name acids that have the prefix hydro and they have two elements. They're called binary acids. Next, we'll learn to name acids that have oxygen. They're called oxyacids. But before we do that, let's talk a little bit about the definition of acids. Acids give off H plus ions in water. So I put an acid in water, it dissolves, and then you get H plus and Cl minus. The H plus is what makes it an acid. Think about pH. The H stands for how many H plus ions there are. And those H plus ions are what make something acetic. Let's write the formula for the not-so-friendly nitric acid. We can see nitric acid does not begin with hydro. So this set of rules right here don't apply. We can see it does end in ic, and we have ic right here, not O-U-S. So these are the rules we'll use to name nitric acid. First, we write the stem. So we have N-I-T-R, and then instead of ic, we're going to put A-T-E. That makes this the nitrate ion, and we'll go to the common ion table to look that up. The common ion table usually is given to you on a test or in class, but check to make sure. It lists ions consisting of two or more elements. So as we go down the common ion table, we're looking for the nitrate ion. So we go down here, we have chlorates, permanganate, nitrite, and here is the nitrate ion. It's NO3-. So we remember NO3-, and we'll go back to our set of rules, and we write NO3, and it had a minus charge. Next, we put H in front, and we know H is plus. When we look to balance our charges, we have a plus and a minus. Those cancel out. And that makes the formula for nitric acid, HNO3. So pause and write the formula for sulfuric acid. Because there's no hydro as a prefix and it ends in IC, we'll use these rules to write the formula. We'll write the stem, the SULF, and then instead of the ic at the end of it, we're going to write 8. We can then look that up on the common ion table, and as we scroll down, I don't see anything here with the negative ones that starts with S. Keep going down, there's silicate, sulfite, and there it is, sulfate, SO4. 2-. So we'll remember that, go back to our rules, and write SO4 2-. Next, we write H in front, and remember H is a positive charge, and now we need to balance these out. Because I have a minus 2, and that applies to this whole SO4 polyatomic ion, this minus 2 needs to be balanced by a plus 2. So if I have two hydrogens, 2 times the plus here, that's plus 2, that'll balance out, and that'll give me a net charge of 0. And that makes H2SO4 the correct formula for sulfuric acid. This is the last set of rules we need to learn to write formulas for acids. When we look at this phosphorus acid here, we can see there's no hydro in the beginning. It ends in OUS. So these are the rules we'll use. So we'll write the stem, and phosphorus is a bit of an exception. The stem, we just write PHOSPH. We leave out the OR. Instead of OUS, we're going to write ITE. That means we have the phosphite ion, and we can go to the common ion table and look up the formula. We scroll down the table, we're looking for phosphite. So I don't see it in the negative 1, negative 2, no. Negative 3, there's phosphite, so we have that. So we remember PO3, 3 minus. Go back to our rules. We write PO3, 3 minus, and then we put H in front. Remember that H has a positive charge, so we're going to need 3 H's here to balance out these 3 minus charges. So we'll put a subscript of 3 here. That means our net charge is 0, and HPO3 is the formula for phosphorus acid. So pause and write the formula for chlorous acid. For chlorous acid, we'll use these rules right here since it ends in OUS. So we write the stem, the CHLOR, and then we change the OUS to ITE. That gives us the chlorite ion. So now we go back over to the common ion table and we look up chlorite. On the common ion table, as we look down, we see that chlorite is ClO2 minus. Back to our rules, and we write ClO2 minus for the chlorite ion. We then write H in front. We know H has a positive charge, and that's going to balance out with the negative charge, so we can just get rid of those. And that makes HClO2 the formula for chlorous acid. Sometimes you'll see an acid like perchloric acid, and you might not recognize the name. Don't be alarmed, we treat it just like any other acid. We see it ends in ic, doesn't begin in hydro, so we use these rules right here. We look up the perchlorate ion on the common ion table, and there it is right there, ClO4 minus. So we write our ClO4 minus, we put H in front, we balance the charges, they're nicely balanced, and that gives us perchloric acid, HClO4. So with these rules, you should be able to write the formulas for all kinds of different acids. There's lots of practice. Follow the link in the description. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.